Troubled by the lack of control it was able to exert over the renegade demons, the ultimate evil traveled north into the Plaguelands. This area was home to the undead, who had eked out an existence there for eons. It was certain they would be eager to join the ultimate evil. After the demons had escaped the ultimate evil, it was very keen to bring undead creatures back under its control. To this end, the evil traveled to an area that was formerly known as the Plaguelands. At one time, a huge cemetery graced the countryside here, providing a happy place for the undead to hang out. Assuming the undead ever had any concept of happiness, that is. But that was 20 years ago. Since then, the Alliance had turned this place into the Poshlands. It was an unbearably good place, which was heavily guarded due to its dubious past. The ultimate evil would first need to take care of those guards and completely destroy the place before it could take control of the undead. Although the Horde was still exposed to constant Alliance attacks, the offensive tactic-loving evil did not hesitate. It sent some cannon fodder, creatures, to the surface. There was a small Alliance military camp to the south, which guarded the border to the Poshlands. An attack from inside the Poshlands would be sure to surprise them. Word of the ultimate evil's presence had spread among the supporters of the Alliance like wildfire. The evil would soon have to deal with their unwillingness to tolerate its presence. Enemies have entered the dungeon. There are enemies in your dungeon. It's payday. There are enemies in your dungeon. There were few that could withstand the ultimate evil's horde. The Alliance's military camps in the south were obviously not amongst those rare few. They disappeared from the surface faster than a brain amidst a horde of zombies. There are enemies in your dungeon.
Payday.
In the east of the Poshlands lay a small alliance camp that looked after the area's agriculture. This wouldn't be of much help against a bunch of crazed orcs. The Alliance's outpost in the east was unable to resist the Horde. Another part of the Poshlands fell to make room for some beautiful tombs, from which undead would soon rise. There are enemies in your dungeon. Enemies in your dungeon. Payday. In the middle of the posh lands, directly at a crossroads, there lay the small but well-fortified village of Bunnyfield. The Alliance would send small attack groups towards the dungeon from here as well. There are enemies in your dungeon. Just in time, or rather better late than never, some of the Horde's troops appeared from the south. They had presumably just come from paying a brief visit to their favorite pub, the Winchester, which was run by two brothers. Whatever. These troops came to help, and the Ultimate Evil could certainly make good use of them. The capital of the posh land lay in the northwest of the country. Hipston. Yes. Granted, a terrible name. But what can you dream of? Despite its ridiculous name, Hipsterbridge was heavily guarded and would resist attack by all means possible. The Horde would have to work hard here to bring the city back into the Plague Lands. There was a tavern in the woods called the Black Boar, one of those classic hero meeting places. A bard stood in front of this establishment, advertising the ultimate evil dungeon in his refrains, which regularly resulted in heroes flooding into the underground, a habit he would soon be losing. The Black Boar Tavern came to an inglorious end after the Horde visited the establishment. They not only refused to pay the tab, but burned the whole taproom down to boot. Well, quite understandable, really. There was no orc beer on tap.
Heyday!
After the Alliance had repeatedly failed with their clumsy wave tactics, the decision was made to overrun the ultimate evil with a single giant attack. Of course, this would fail, but it would be close. Very close. In the north, the Plague Lands, or maybe Crash Lands, were bordered by an insurmountable wall of solid ice. No one knew what lay beyond in the wilds of the north. Although, rumors of terrible monsters and the like abounded. Someday, the ultimate evil would love to spend a holiday there. Not all of the Plague Lands had been conquered by the Alliance. One area was so especially steeped in evil that it could not be cultivated at all. It was quickly covered with a magical spell and surrounded by a massive wall. An entrance would probably only be found once the rest of the posh lands had been destroyed. Most Alliance forces have been defeated, and with them, the armies of good have been driven back, for the time being at least. Now it was time to change tack and start the attack. The Poshlands now needed to be restored to their former glory.
It's the Slender Man! Run!
Oh, sorry, just my shadow.
Mission accomplished. The Poshlands were history, so three cheers for the Plaguelands. It wouldn't be long before the undead would rise again. Skeletons, zombies, white wanderers, well, maybe not the latter. And rise they did. To be honest, they were actually less than the astounded evil expected, but still. It used its mental abilities to reach out to them in order to seize them and to bring them under its control. But the evil did not succeed. Another power had already taken possession of them. A massive shape rose from a crypt in the east. It started to speak in the ultimate evil's direction.
You hold no power here. I will only obey the King of Gondor. I mean the ultimate evil. It is time for you to die, O living ones.
This was a tad unexpected for the ultimate evil. It would seem there was an imposter out there trying to usurp its title. It would have to worry about that later, though. This threat had to be dealt with first, as the undead were obviously baying for a fight with the Horde. It could safely be assumed that whoever was controlling the undead was doing so from somewhere up in the wild region of the Plaguelands. The ultimate evil would need to send its troops there in order to eliminate this threat. Once again, the strange figure appeared, just like it had done several times before. The creatures of the unspeakable evil paused, confused, uncertain what to do.
You fool! I warned you not to start a civil war! For that, you will pay!
With these words, the mysterious figure disappeared once again. Probably hadn't had enough breakfast. Never mind. There's a skeleton king in the crypt just waiting to be pounded into a pulp by the Horde. You shouldn't keep him waiting. That would be rude.
plague lands and the unpleasantly swanky posh lands. It was incredible what a little paint could do.
This is where the dead do rest. There is no place for the living here. Meet my sword. Frostguard is hungry.
It was obvious that negotiations were not an option here. Therefore, the powerful evil chose one of its most well-proven tactics to solve the problem. Hit it till it stops moving. It's payday. Once, the Plaguelands were a cozy place for the undead. However, after the ultimate evil's fall, the place was taken over by a group known as the Crimson Crusade. They transformed it into the Poshlands. They even made a film about it, a very sad story called Unlife is Beautiful. Enemies have entered the dungeon. Thank you. the Skeleton King was unable to withstand the unspeakable evil's creatures and crumbled to dust under their mighty blows like a vampire in sunlight. Just like a proper vampire does. One of those little twilight wuzzes. The undead remained completely unimpressed and steadfastly refused to be controlled by the ultimate evil. Something out there was stopping them. However, without a leader, they were no longer a threat to the Horde. They just trudged about mindlessly, completely devoid of control. They were therefore useless to the ultimate evil. So the evil pushed on towards King's Ending in order to destroy the Alliance's remaining heroes there.